All right, well, it's towards the end of June, and it's Pittsburgh Ghost Snake Hunting 2019 edition. We got Sweeney again coming up along with John Nugent. This time we're going to have Luke Sweeney's brother along with us this time. And we're staying along Hicks Run at Camp Critter. This place is absolutely beautiful. We're right along Hicks Run where we can catch trout, and the cabin inside is amazing. Lots of room, perfect for snake camper, right in the middle of snake territory here. We got our snake license, we're ready to go. We might do some trout fishing here this weekend and just see how many snakes we can find. Well, these guys showed up late last night, but we're ready to go. We got John Nugent, Luke Sweeney, and his brother.
Brian Sweeney.
You've probably seen him in a duck hunt video that we did. Ready to go hunt. You guys ready?
Yes, sir.
As ready as we can be.
We're going to film them, make sure they don't fall in.
Yeah.
No. He's not.
All right, we're starting the snake hunt. We're on a good line where we found lots of snakes before. And it's getting really hot. Sun's really hot, but it rained a little bit just a little while ago, first thing in the morning. But hopefully these snakes are gonna be out trying to catch a little bit of sun. If they get too hot, you know, and the sun gets too hot, then they'll actually stay under the rocks because the snakes have to regulate their body temperature since they're cold-blooded. Lots of snake food here. Oh, we just spotted this little black phase in the middle of shedding. Pretty cool looking. Yeah, he's buzzing.
And he's shedding like crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Johnny, we got a picture of my brother holding a snake.
Yeah. So you caught your very first snake, or held your very first snake. There you go. Yep. Showing these guys just to, you don't have to squeeze them real tight. We put some stuff on our tongs to help soften the metal on them. They might look like they're squeezing them hard, but it really isn't. The snake usually flattens themselves out because they're used to going underneath rocks. And you can see he's a-okay. Gonna let him go and hunt for more. Taking a break and did a pretty good hike today. And what, how many snakes?
Four, seven,
three.
Three?
See
possibly one? Well, I heard four. There was a snake skin and I heard one slither underneath the rock, but he never rattled. So it is really hot, the sun is just beating down, and so far all those snakes are either in the shade or they're underneath the rocks, right next to the rocks, and they're zipping back in before we can actually get to them. Some of this stuff is actually getting hunted and pressured, so the snakes are a little bit more sensitive to vibrations, and getting close to them, they get away pretty quick. So, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we saw a bear.
Yes, we did see a bear, and so...
Right after the deer.
We're going to head back out. Maybe we'll see some snakes in some places that we didn't see on the way in, and maybe hit a different spot.
Got one right there. Probably going to go underneath the rock. It's in between those two rocks. I don't know if you'll get him because he's getting ready to bolt.
Oh, yeah. He's going. He's tiny.
Yeah, he's a little guy. Really little.
Yeah.
Not going to mess with him. We found a giant shed.
I think it's an elk.
Think it's an elk?
Yeah, elk. Why would I pay so much to go hunting?
Oh, Sweeney caught another one. Coming down. Yep, little one. There's another one underneath this rock.
That was the biggest one.
There's another one down there.
There's a skin.
Yeah, there's a skin. Bunch of small ones. Oh, yeah. He wasn't too far underneath there. He's right there.
Yeah.
Pretty nice. All right. Now we're getting into the snakes. How many is that?
Eight
snakes so far. All right. Cool. So we're on our way back from the hunt. We only saw 10 rattlesnakes. And almost ran this one over. He's got a nice rattle on him, real nice black one. He just shed. His head was literally right here. And so these guys in the back, they're like, hey, rattlesnake. So,
John, are you sure that snake isn't legal? He's folded.
Yeah, that's not a legal snake.
How long do you think he is?
He's going to be in the high 30s.
Okay.
Well, we're in Driftwood, and we're going to stop here at the Driftwood Grill and get something to eat. Buck and a cow and another cow. There's, look at those bucks.
Oh yeah.
Two right there. That one looks like there's another one buck.
That's a nice one.
Yeah.
Is that another elk out there in the middle?
Look at all those deer.
Yeah, there's a pile of deer.
There's two right there. Yeah, okay, that's
there's one. Another buck. Two more buck.
What is planted here? Get this.
Clover.
Clover. Red clover.
Yeah, look at the size of that.
The size difference.
White tail buck beside a cow doe or cow elk. All right, we're heading out. We're going to go hunt a little bit in the morning.
John Nugent here, Leatherwood Outdoors. It's the final day. What is it? June
30th.
The 30th. June 30th, we're going to go. For the final day of our rattlesnake trip, boys from Pittsburgh go rattlesnake hunting 2.0. Got John behind the wheel of the truck, and if you can see back there, the man van, Sween and his brother are following us. Had to be out of the place by 11. By the way, it was a pretty nice cabin to stay in. Hoping today that we can find ourselves at least a legal snake to tube. Not necessarily would we have to keep one, but I'd like to see a bigger snake today. Yeah, yesterday's fishing was hit or miss. All right, off the woods.
So, John driving down the road and saw this little wood turtle. A little guy.
We don't want him turning into a smash little turtle like we saw that one on the road yesterday.
Put him back off the road.
Ah, he's clawing my fingers.
Don Nugent, the turtle saver. All right. Out on the line again. Got John inside the rocks. Trying to find some snakes. All right. Luke caught a really nice yellow face. Pretty cool.
He's getting ready to shed. His eyes are all glazed over.
Yeah, just a little bit. We're going to tube him and see how long he is. All right, so I'm going to show these guys again how to tube a snake. He's going to be in probably high 30s. I don't know if he'll make legal status or not. But you want to grab them in the middle of the body. You don't want to grab the snake near the head or the tail because that's where it's more fragile. And so you want to grab the snake in the meatier part of the body, in the center. You don't want to have a death grip on the snake, just enough to keep him from moving around. If he gets through the tongs a little bit, you can go ahead and just let him go.
See if we can get him here. Try to work his head up in the tube here. I'm just using my foot just to help stabilize him. I'm not putting any weight, real hard weight, down on his body. Just gonna keep using the tongs, keep my hands far away. Then I'm gonna grab him right here where he comes, have a good grip on him.
Oh, I see him.
That's how you tube a rattlesnake. Now, in the state of Pennsylvania, you have to have a snake that's 42 inches long and it has to be a male.
Hey, hold on. Time for 1 second. Brian Pan over here.
Oh, we caught another one.
He's much smaller than that.
Just gonna let him go.
You can put him back in a hole. Another yellow face. There you go. All right, back to your speech.
Yeah, it's starting to come out now. But how we're gonna find out if it's a male or a female is right here where the vent is. These are called subcaudal scales. So we count these scales. 21 or more is considered a male. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. So this is definitely considered a male. He has buttons here. Each one of these is, he gains a button on his rattle each time he sheds his skin. So he might shed his skin several times a year and he'll gain a button. So you can't tell the age by that, but he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 buttons on his rattle. And if you want to measure them, okay, we're just going to give a real quick rough estimate. So just hold that right there at the tip of his head. Even though we're not going to get every kink, we're not going to force it too much.
Oh, that is a very close snake. John.
Yeah, he is getting
that
close.
Is a very, very legal.
Let's see.
I think that is a very, very legal 44 inch snake.
Is he really? Look at that. That's definitely 42 inches with a bunch of kinks.
This big kink in the neck right
there. That is a 44 inch snake.
That's at least 44, yeah.
You taking that one?
He's not real big and fat, but you want to do one more measurement?
Let's get real right. Let's get real right. You want to do about the head here?
Yeah, just put it right.
Okay, John, you grab a hold of him. I have 43 inches to the bottom button.
Yeah, we don't measure the rattle when you're measuring.
Look, 43 right there.
Yep.
Did we already count the subcaudals? He's a male?
Yep. All right, so here's how we're going to let him go. Just to get him out of the tube. Actually, we're going to leave him in the tube because we're going to probably, if you're going to tag him out. Okay. All right. So Sweeney's going to tag out with a yellow phase. Timber rattlesnake.
First one ever.
Congrats.
Thank you.
He's pretty dark. You're going to have to let him shed.
He'll shed out. Luke with his very first tag out on a timber rattlesnake. That is awesome.
Follow us at Leatherwood Outdoors on Instagram.
Look at his eyes there. Yellow phase, has yellow eyes. Usually a yellow head. How you can tell the difference between a yellow phase and a black phase. They usually get black towards the rattle. And there's nothing inside the rattle, it's just that the rattle grows in and out. You can see how it's like in an accordion, because these can just break off real easy. They're fragile, there's nothing inside. It's just the vibration that makes it rattle.
Usually just take a pillow sack, put them inside a pillow sack. I'm gonna do this for Luke. Make sure he's clear to the bottom. And then I'll hold right here. And just sort of work this up like this. Keep the tube way down in. There it goes. Keep them down in. And there we go. And then I'm just gonna lightly step on the side here. Tie this into a knot.
Luke, you know, talk to my brother. Get it tanned.
All right, there he is. Now, Luke has to fill out his tag.
You gotta fill out your snake tag.
Take his. And after he fills out, he is no longer allowed to touch another timber rattlesnake. He is allowed to still catch a copperhead with his license, but as soon as he tags out on a snake, he can no longer even handle another timber rattlesnake. So he's pretty much just an observation guy now the rest of the hunt. And so we'll see how many more we can find.
Snake, not a dark.
So, filling out the tag.
25 subscribe.
43. Yeah. Right, is that how many I counted? 43? Or 25?
Yeah, 25.
43 inches.
25 scales. Yeah. Subcaudal scales. 43 and a half inches long.
Yeah,
He tried. They said they thought they saw one come in and John come around the other corner, and that's a fat one right there. You want to measure them, tube them? That's a fat snake. We'll just play with them right here. It's a nice one.
John.
Do you want to tube him?
Yeah. I do. He's going to be a pretty snake.
All right, let's tube him.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
Remember that place that you've never been before?
Yeah. This
first
is a new snake. Spot. This
first
is a new
snake
spot.
Of this new spot.
We said, let's go try a new spot we've never been to before. We had no idea whether we were going to find snakes or not. But with so many snakes in the state of Pennsylvania, chances are good when you're in a remote area, you're going to find snakes. All right, hold them up there. I'm going to stand
He's just shedding. Just shedding.
Yeah, he's going to be he's got some really nice.
I'm ecstatic.
Wow, look at that. I mean, you'll be able to take that off yourself with how he's coming off.
You saw me shaking with the tube. My appreciation for this is just unreal.
Follow Leatherwoods on Instagram.
Look at that snake.
All right, we're going to put him in the sack. Alright.
Nope, I gotta fill out the tag now.
John's gonna fill out his tag, and now John is not allowed to handle or touch another rattlesnake.
You're on your own, homie.
But he can keep his tongs and continue looking for a copperhead. We're done snake hunting for the weekend, and John tagged out on a snake. Now Sweeney was videotaping the measurement and forgot to push record. So big fail
from the fat guy.
So, but anyways, we did, I don't know if we mentioned, we haven't looked through the footage, we were trying to see what all we filmed, but it was
44 inches and 23 caudal scales.
Yep, so.
Black phase male.
John tagged out, Luke tagged out, and total snakes for the weekend?
14.
So a lot of people asked the last time what we do with our snakes. So John, what are you gonna do with your snake?
Well, my brother, he got one last year, and he kind of learned and Google searched and whatnot, figured out how to skin it, tan the hide, and I plan on doing the same thing with my snake. I like to pin my snake, tan the hide, and we're definitely going to cook it up like we did with Luke's last year. I think Sweeney, he plans on doing something similar.
When you're out to tag to kill the snake, we're not just killing it for a useless purpose. We are using the meat, preserving the hide, and there's other guys that have been in our videos that have just kept the snake. You can keep it as a pet if you want, and you can also keep it for a short while and let it go back into the wild and just use it as a show-off piece, a talking piece to show people or to teach people about the rattlesnake. And so there's more than just when we say tagged out, we're allowed just one a year, and that doesn't necessarily mean every time that we're killing the snake. But in John's instance and in Luke's instance, they're gonna be killing and preserving the hide. We have a video on our second channel, Leatherwood Outdoors 2, and it's called How to Kill, Gut Clean, and Skin a Rattlesnake, and How to Preserve the Skin. And so if any of you guys want to know how that's done, I'll put a link at the end of the video or right here. Just click on the card right here and I'll take you to that video.
Yeah, this is just an enjoyable trip for me. And for a while there, John's been trying to get me to come out and do this. And I'm I'm so grateful. I'm elated about the fact that Luke and I both are going to tag out this year together. It's cool to do with a friend that I've had for so long.